In just 12 days' time, the people of Greece will vote again to elect a new parliament after failing last month to form a coalition government. The election comes at a pivotal time for Greece and, watching on, a nervous Europe. The prospect of Greece reneging on its debt and pulling out of the euro is making markets around the world jittery and currencies fluctuate wildly. Last month's inconclusive election saw an immediate sharp fall in the Australian dollar, a sign of just how interconnected we now all are. The orthodoxies of politics here have collapsed. Almost out of nowhere, hard right parties and the radical left have emerged to engulf the mainstream parties. First up tonight, we take a look at the new players who are changing the landscape of Greek politics.
As Alexis Tsipras enters a suburban hall in Athens, it's not just Greek voters who are keen to hear him talk. World leaders, bankers and investors are just as keen to hear and dissect his every word, probably more so. Tsipras and his coalition of the radical left, or Syriza, is leading the first significant left-wing challenge to the international monetary system in a generation, and is now in striking distance to form a government. His populist, expansive message is electrifying an electorate exhausted with economic decline and sending chills through the rest of Europe. The laws he's referring to are to renege on Greece's debt of more than $200 billion, to tear up the memorandum of agreement with the EU. It's feared that if he succeeds and other stressed European nations follow his lead, the euro will collapse and possibly the European Union itself. There's a lot riding on this Greek election.
It's very difficult to describe to people outside Greece just how hard the situation is getting.
Nick Melkoutsis is a journalist and editor with one of Greece's major dailies, Kathimerini. It's midday as we walk the empty streets of what was once a bustling shopping centre.
They're all closing down here.
Yeah, right? There's a lot of shops. You go anywhere, the shopping streets, and you see shops closing one after the other.
The hard times have suited anti-austerity parties like Syriza.
Well, if you look at the May 6 elections, Syriza, the leftist coalition, is clearly the big win, although it came second, more than tripled its share of the votes since the 2009 elections. You know, a few years ago it was a party that would get 5-6% and was a minor player in Greek politics, and now to be in a position where, in the heart of this crisis, they might have a chance to form a government is quite an incredible change.
Even if the loans were totally wiped out, Greece still has a $4 billion annual deficit. It's still unclear exactly how Tsipras intends to fund the promised increases in pensions and the public service.
Καθώς και η θέσπιση αυστηρών ποινών, δίμευσης μέρους της περιουσίας για όσους συλλαμβάνονται να δηλώνουν ψευδώς τα περιουσιακά της υγείας.
Tsipras is good at making speeches.
Questions for Australian TV.
Why not, sir?
But not so good at giving answers, proving remarkably reluctant to talk to either local or international media. The task of explaining his coalition's emerging policies increasingly falling on others.
You've certainly ruffled a lot of feathers. Everyone's watching it.
Well, we hope so, because we think the feathers have to be ruffled.
Euclid Sakalotos is an economics professor at Athens University and is the finance spokesperson for Syriza, presumably the future Minister of Finance if the party wins government.
Well, you're winning a lot of votes here, but you're not winning many friends internationally. Does that worry you?
Well, it's not quite the case that we're not winning friends internationally. There's a lot of interest in what we're doing. And
a lot of interest, but a lot of suspicion. I mean,
there is a suspicion because we've had a Europe that's been going in one direction for 20 years, and the first person who breaks that is obviously going to rustle some feathers, and people are going to be afraid, anxious, not clear what's going on. But we're trying to explain what we're trying to do, that what we're trying to do is to change things in a more progressive, in a more socially just manner, a more democratic manner. And I think some people are beginning to understand that.
But others, neighbours who are picking up the bill, aren't quite so understanding.
It's become probably a common insult that you've heard many times by now, that why should German taxpayers have to work even harder to support Greek workers who probably don't pay enough tax as it is?
It depends whether you want to be a monetary union or not. And if you want to be a monetary union, you share in the gains and you share in the costs.
If you want to be in a monetary union, you need to abide by fundamental undertakings that you make to that union. You borrow money, you pay it back as the premise, as the basis.
If you can pay it back. If you can't pay it back, and I don't think any of the southern European economy...
Does it worry you? Do you feel any shame if you can't pay it back? Does it concern
you? No, because shame. The key issue, when banks lend too much, half the fault is theirs, half the fault is the borrowers.
Yes.
And you're not going to sort that out unless you get together the
borrowers. But aren't you even taking half the fault? Why don't you say you'll pay half back?
What we are saying is, under current conditions, we won't pay it back. There's the Greece will go bankrupt because of these policies, well, so we have to find another way.
It's not just the left who have marched forward over the ashes of the previous government. The hard right party, Golden Dawn, under its veteran leader Nikos Makalalaikos, has also come to prominence, winning 21 seats in the parliament.
Well, if you look at it, it's a phenomenal rise. In 2009, late 2009, when we had our last election, they got 0.29%, less than 0.5%. And at these elections, they got 7%. Proportionally, I don't know if there's been a rise in such a short space of time. Certainly, I don't think in Greek politics. So it's a huge shock to the political system.
But not a shock for party deputy Elias Panayiotaros.
Were you happy with the election results?
Yes, I'm going to be more happy. We're going to be happier on the 17th of June.
Why do you think you've had increased popularity?
Because we're saying the right things. We're the only ones that are talking about patriotism, nationalism, about our religion, about our nation, about everything, without being afraid.
Look, they reject any association with fascism or the Nazi Party. They say that we are just
nationalists.
Yeah. I think that the facts challenge that.
As much as they would each hate the comparison, the left and the right share some strikingly common views. They're both virulently opposed to international banks, large corporations, and the economic tentacles of the EU. And both have harvested votes out of the dreaded debt memorandum.
What we're seeing here is this emergence of more hard left-wing parties, of which you are. You're getting very, very hard right-wing parties like Golden Dawn. Does that concern you?
It concerns me desperately, but I have to look at the reasons why right-wing populism and fascistic parties are rising. And they always rise when large sections of the working class or the middle class do not have any prospects, when they lose their savings or when they lose their jobs, when they're working poor, because we have this phenomenon now which used to not used to used to be not to be the case, of people who are working and are poor. So if these people have not got any prospects and they have no political parties that are representing them in the political process, they are politically homeless, and some of them will go to very right-wing and dangerous parties.
Yeah, but you've got elements, you get pretty hard Marxists in your party too.
But what we are trying to do is actually represent these people on a social agenda. So the question really is not why the hard left, which is your term, not mine, but let's go with it, is gaining, is why social democratic parties are not addressing their social base. And the answer to the problem is, if they don't address the social base, somebody else will.
Tonight, Golden Dawn marched towards Parliament. No longer the eternal outsiders of Greek politics. Undoubtedly, after June 17, a good number of them will be marching straight through the front door to take up their seats. With the previous government's austerity program cutting into the public service, demonstrations, this one by firemen claiming they haven't been paid, are a daily occurrence.
I'm angry. I want to kill him.
You want to kill who?
Yes.
Who?
Everything. Everyone. The politicals. Okay, the government. I don't know.
It is into this volatile mix that Alexis Tsipras has arrived with an apparently magical formula. Increased pensions, bigger public service and no debt. All the things that Greeks have been told for years that they can't have, now they can, according to the Syriza finance chief.
Hasn't Greece been in something of a time warp when the rest of the world 30 years ago realised you should keep your public debt down, you should encourage private enterprise? You'd be just entrenching the same notion that the government's going to come in and help.
Well, I think there is a sea change after 2008, that the state is necessary. I remind you that the crisis, the world crisis, didn't begin either in status Greece or status France. It began in neoliberal Britain and neoliberal America, in the more liberal economies. The problem in the last 20 years is that the social democratic parties, the centre-left parties, have stopped representing their social base. There has been no programme of the centre-left on pensions, on wages, on social welfare. And that has meant that large sections of society are politically homeless. It is absolutely vital, not just for the economy, but for democracy, for those people to be re-represented, to feel that they have a stake in society.
Εμείς, φίλες και φίλοι, διαφέρουμε από τις δυνάμεις που επί 37 χρόνια εναλλάχθηκαν στη διακυβέρνηση του τόπου.
One of the great ironies of this election is that the two mainstream parties, the Conservative New Democracy and the centre-left PASOK party, old enemies, may be forced to form an alliance to try to stave off Tsipras forming a government.
These are two parties that for 38 years were at each other's throats and took it in turns ruling Greece and had a very polarised political dialogue. But now reality is staring them in the face.
There's another enemy at the gate.
Exactly. I mean, and politicians are very good at knowing how to survive, and this is about survival.
Two polls in recent days have placed Tsipras's coalition in the lead. Win or lose, his coalition of the radical left has normalised the notion that Greece can walk away from its debt, from the euro and the EU if it has to, and from the neoliberal conventions that have so firmly gripped the West in recent decades.
You have to provide working people and middle-class people with some agenda of jobs and pensions and growth. Even if not now, at least a prospect in 1 year and 2 years, make some sacrifices, but there's light at the end of the tunnel. If you don't do that, the euro will break up anyway, and we will get back to the kind of 1930s politics that we really want to avoid.
Euclid Sakalotis outlining his vision for Greece and for Europe.